My name is Christian Seiler and I am a plant biologist.
On our hunt to find the genes that differ between plants that grow happily and the ones that grow unhappy on an unbalanced diet, we cross the two plants to mix the genomes. Then we grew those plants with the mixed genomes under the same stressful conditions and measured them. To link the happiness of the plants to the differently mixed genomes, we have to read the genomes. In the last episode, we extracted the DNA. Now we have to create the libraries to read it.
Here we are in the Genome Diversity Center of the ETH in Zurich. This is a common lab space where any scientists come in and do the lab work if you don't have your own lab, which is fabulous. I'm here to make sequencing libraries.
When we have a lot of samples, we use a pipetting robot to be more accurate with the volumes.
So this thing is called a sonicator, and it fragments the DNA. So basically splits up this long text into smaller sections, which we then can read.
The ultrasound generates a lot of heat in a small DNA sample. That's why this tiny tube sits in a big pool of cold water. To know to which sample this smaller DNA sections belong to, we have to add molecular identifiers. These molecular identifiers are short stretches of DNA of a known sequence. To clean up our sequencing libraries, or in other words, remove all the dirt, we add a suspension of magnetic beads. The DNA binds to the surface of those beads, which we can push aside using a magnet and remove the liquid with all the dirt. As a final step, we quantify, that is, how much sequencing library do we have in each tube, and check the quality.
After a full day in the lab, we have our sequencing libraries. Now we ship them off to a sequencing center. If you like this video, make sure to let me know by subscribing, liking it, or leaving a comment, or all three of those. Until next time, bye-bye!